Hi viewer, I welcome you to Erim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies, form 2, lesson number 19. The topic it is communication. I'm your tutor, Rosie Modoni. Welcome. In our previous lesson, we managed to talk about the forms of communication. So we managed to look at the forms of communication, where we talked about the verbal communications or the oral communications. We also discussed about the written communication, and today I want us to look at the audiovisual communication. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to explain the different forms of audiovisual communications and also state their advantages and disadvantages of using the audiovisual communication, forms of communication. Now, we start by looking at the forms of communications. When I talk about the audiovisual communication, it is the communication in which messages are sent through sounds and signs. So audiovisual means it is sounds and signs. All those informations that are accompanied by the sounds and signs. And then we say that is an audiovisual. It is something that you can hear, audio. It is something that you can be able to see, the signs. So that is the reason as to why I refer to it as the audiovisual communication. The means of communication are siren. So siren, it is one. You can hear the sound of the ambulance. You can also get the signs. It is breaking red. So it is a matter of you seeing the and hearing the sound. Then number two, it is the television. You can hear what the TV is saying, and also you can see the images. We have the photographs being the next one. Photographs, they talk a lot. Can be able to see the images, signs, gestures, and drawings. You can also have the videos, other chats and whistles. So you can have them like that. We go to the advantages. Now, when we talk about the siren, it will get to many people than the way we communicate in other ways. For example, if at all it is a written message, written form, it does not give sound. You can't see it passing. It is just silent unless you receive it and then you read it. But when we talk about the siren, you see it. The signs. You also hear the sound. So in this case, you are going to get even the person who is not intended, or that person who is even at his or a room, you have to get to the message. There is an ambulance that is passing and it is saying, give me the way. Then if at all someone has raised the written document, the poster, give me the way. So it gets to many people than expected, than any other form of communication. Number two, it is more appealing than other means of communication. Because what you feel when you hear and you get the signs, it is more it moves you more than the written document, the one that you can see, it is written there. But when you hear and also you see the signs, then it becomes more appealing to you. Either you are the one who is receiving the message or even sending the message, it becomes more appealing. Number three, it reinforces verbal communication. Yes. After passing or after sending a verbal communication, it might be accompanied by the Things that you can be able to see. Things that you can be able to feel. So it reinforces whatever I say. For example, I say, stand up. And then I start myself. Then it means even that person who was not aware, who has not heard whatever I've said, I've used the verbal, but someone has not heard me whatever I've said. But when he sees others standing up, he just stand up the same way like the others. So in that case now, it has assisted the verbal communication to be heard by everyone, to be received by everyone. Next. May have a lasting effect on the receiver. After you see and you have the audio, you hear and see. That one you cannot forget about it. But the written one, the one that you are reading or you just hearing, it can fade away very fast. Next, suitable where receivers are illiterate. So those people who have never stepped in class, who don't know how to read, who don't know how to write, they receive the audiovisual messages very, very comfortably. Disadvantages. It is only suitable for those people who can interpret the meaning correctly. So unless you can be able to understand the meaning of the siren crying, if the ambulance is passing, it means give me the way. And yet, if at all you don't understand that, it is telling you to give me the way, then you cannot give that way. So you need to understand the meaning of the siren. What is the meaning of the siren when the ambulance, when the given car gives you the siren, it tells you, give me the way. So you should be able to understand the meaning of that or to interpret the message correctly. Number two, it is not suitable for sending confidential messages because even it goes to people who are not supposed to receive the message. Remember we said that this one goes to many people, as many as possible. Next, preparation may take long. For you to prepare an audiovisual forms of communication, it requires you to take a long period of time. Activity. Discuss advantages and disadvantages of audio-visual communication. Reference. You can get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, Dand Edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to NTV. Thank you.